Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a very exciting video because today I get to review and own my very first Once Upon a Time figure. And it is of my favorite character in the show, the Evil Queen, aka Regina Mills. I'm so excited for this figure. She came in yesterday. Back in 2014, I want to say 2014 or 2015, pretty sure 2014, they announced that they were coming out with Once Upon a Time figures. There were no images or anything. They just announced that they were going to come soon. And then I think in 2015 or 2016, I can't remember, they finally released pictures of the figure and what they were going to look like, and the first series, and who was going to be in it, and Regina was in it, and I went on the site Icon Heroes, and they kept getting pushed back since, like, 2015, and pushed back every time. They said, oh, this figure will be out in August, oh, this figure will be out in November, but it kept getting pushed back. Finally, as you can see, they were finally put out. And I'm so excited, because I've been waiting for figures of that show to come out for years. And it's my favorite show, so, you can get this figure at Icon Heroes along with the other characters in the wave. I also got the 300 limited statue of Regina. She's in the same outfit, but I will do a video of that soon. I just want to get this open. So what we're going to do is take a look at the box before anything. At the top, we have the Icon Heroes logo. This is the site you can get them off. I mean, you can get them off eBay too, but sometimes it's just better to get them on the official site. It says ages 18 plus, not sure why, because Once Upon a Time is a family show, or supposed to be. I mean, it can get graphic sometimes, but, you know what I mean. Then we have the Once Upon a Time logo, and then it says Evil Queen. Surprised they called her Evil Queen on here, because I do have the Funko Pops of Regina, except that San Diego Comic-Con Regina. I'll get her one day. And they just say Regina. So interesting they went with Evil Queen on here. And then the side, you can see in the background, which I'll show when I take the figure out, the trees. Every time they do the Once Upon a Time intro, there's always the trees in the background. It's on the back. Then we get ABC Once Upon a Time logo. Then on this side, we get a really pretty picture of Lana Parrilla as the Evil Queen with Once Upon a Time and ABC logo. And then on the back, it says Once Upon a Time, Series 1, and then you can see the trees, and there's always some little character running through. And then Series 1 contains Emma Swan, Evil Queen, Hook, and Robin Hood. There is another Emma figure that is in a blue jacket. I believe it's an exclusive. And then there's a Toys R Us exclusive of Killian Jones with two hands. I find it funny that the first waves are not Emma and Regina and then their boyfriends, which I didn't ship either one of them, so. But I still want the figures. So then there's the bottom. So what I'm going to do is spend a little time on getting this figure out, and I'll be right back. Okay, and we are back with Regina out of the box, and I am loving this figure. So excited to have this figure. This is the outfit. She, as you guys know if you watch the show, when Regina is the Evil Queen, she wears so many different outfits. So many different beautiful outfits. But this is the outfit she first wore in the first half of season 4 when the Snow Queen came. And I think it was the winter finale. You know, when they take a break every winter. And the Snow Queen cast a curse, Ingrid cast a curse, and it made everyone turn against each other, and it reverted Regina, because at this time she already redeemed herself, or was working on it, back to the Evil Queen, and she wore this outfit. And since then, this outfit has been worn by her a couple times through the show, out the show. She wore it this past season a couple of times, or the Evil Queen did. So yeah, so we've seen it, and not my favorite outfit, but I can see why they did. It's probably one of the more action-packed outfits. You know, when you're buying an action figure, you want action. Instead of just putting her in a gown she wears. Although I do hope, because there's supposed to be a series 2, and I think Snow, Charming, Belle, and Henry are supposed to be in it. I could be wrong. I just heard that from someone. I hope in future series, they do, like, their storybook versions, like Regina. And I think that's the reason why they put Evil Queen on the box instead of Regina, because they were saving that. Maybe they're saving it for when they make a Mayor Mills figure. So, enough rambling, and let's get into the figure. Her articulation is a ball-jointed head. A slight ball-hinged shoulder. Not much. I don't know if it's just stiff, but I don't want to mess it up, so we're just going to leave it that way. Ball-hinged elbows. Hinged wrist. No movement in the waist or torso. Hinged hips, but is a little hindered by this part here. Hinged knees and hinged ankles. So, pretty good articulation. You could get her in good poses and stuff if you want. Let's go ahead and take a look at, we're gonna start from the bottom because that's probably not the most exciting part of the figure. And she is wearing the, just black boots. Not very long boots, they go about to there. With black pants, and usually when she wears black pants in the show, they're very tight black pants. And they're heels, or pumps, or whatever you want to call them. And they look very cool. We all know that Once Upon a Time is a Disney show, because ABC, or Disney owns ABC, but sometimes the characters on Once Upon a Time can be a lot like their Disney animated counterparts, or in this case, very different from their animated counterparts. Like, Frozen was the same, Brave was the same, Cruella was a little bit of the same too. And a lot of that is because of Disney, because they say don't change it. And sometimes they're not so strict with it. And that's the case with the Evil Queen in Once Upon a Time. She doesn't look like her animated counterpart. Although I think they do look a lot alike in the face. If you put a picture of the face of Regina and then the animated Evil Queen, I think they look a lot alike. I don't think she's ever gonna wear the animated outfit throughout. In the show. I kind of like that because that kind of makes them each their own character. But let's continue into the figure. Now we are where her torso is, and you can see some gold silver paint going up, and you can see just a lot of embroidery throughout the outfit. It's very nicely painted, and on her, yeah, well, they're right there too. And she does have a very nice necklace on, which I think is removable. But I'm not going to remove it because I don't see a point. And then she does have the embroidery inside of her collar too. And then she does have these very pointy shoulders. And then she does have the embroidery on her sleeve there too. And then she has this long train, I guess that's what you would call it. And there's the back very nicely, and this little skirt thing, which is now nicely sculpted as well with the nice molds and folds as well as in the back too. And you can see more of the embroidery there. But this is it's a soft rubber long, I guess, train, that's what you call it. And I like it because it does help the figure to stand a little bit. And I like the inside. It is a maroon reddish color, an Evil Queen color, so very nice color. You know, it is an Evil Queen color. I have a poster, actually, with her in this outfit on. I think the hair is very nicely done. It is sculpted well. I think it's the right color and everything. It looks very nice, in my opinion. And, you know, she really doesn't wear crowns. I mean, she wears crowns a couple times in the show, throughout the show, but, I mean, I guess her hair counts as a crown, you know, because they're so big and stuff. That brings us to the face sculpt. I think the face sculpt is amazing. It looks just like Lana Parrilla. It's probably not, dead on, exactly, but it does look a lot like Lana Parrilla. I think they did a very good job. Have red lipstick, right? She's wearing red lipstick, and, she is doing a... She does have a beauty mark, which she does have in real life. And, so it's very cool. Very good job on this figure. So that's pretty much the figure. Very beautiful figure. And let's go over her accessories now. She does come with quite a few. She comes with two interchangeable hands. And they're open, so... We're actually going to save this for last. So, one of her accessories is a mirror. And unfortunately, when I was taking it out of the box, I was cutting it out of the box, I scratched it. Just needs some silver paint, and that's all. And it's just silver. It would have been nice if it was an actual mirror. But, yeah, it's not... Nothing too special about that. But she can hold it. It would have been cool if they gave her a sword. Because she did sword fight in, that... episode. Very cool. She can hold it. It is a little loose in her hand, but, you know, once you get her on a shelf, it will stay fine. And then this hand is kind of like she is, I'm going to take the mirror out so I don't lose it, like she is holding something. There is a peg hole in there, and she comes with both, of course, an apple. Because that's just very evil queen. And it's just a red apple. And then she comes with a heart. That, because, you know, throughout the show, she rips people's hearts out and crushes them. And I'll show you what the apple looks like. And all you have to do is, peg the apple. Now, it's not going to be, like, sitting in her hand like a normal apple. She's actually holding it. Just sideways, so it's not one, you know, she's just, like, kind of, sorry, my phone, someone texted me, holding it, like, offering the apple, you know, it's not, like, a standing up apple, so I think it looks cool like that, it's good to have the peg because, you know, that way it won't fall out. But I think since my statue of her is holding the apple, I think I, and you can switch them out anytime you want, I'm gonna have her hold the heart. And the heart is very cool too. I think it is nicely sculpted. You just do the same thing. I think the heart looks a little better than the apple. It's a little, and you just put it in the hand, and there's your heart. So it looks very cool. As I said, my my statue that I got of her, which I would do a video on, is holding an apple. So I think I'm gonna have her hold the heart this time. And, you know, I always could switch her out if I want. And then I'm just gonna... So, there are those two hands. I was gonna put the mirror, but So, you just take the hands out, and there's no pegs. They're peg holes, which I kind of like better. That way you can pull the hands out, and you don't have to worry about breaking them. And... Wait, I think I might have just used the wrong hand. And they're just open hands. And for some reason, that was very scary. You want to be careful pulling these pegs out still, because the pegs could break. And I thought that was what was... I thought that was going to happen just now. And, I don't think I'm going to keep these hands in, but, sorry, I keep getting text. I just wanted to show for the video. And they're just open hands, if you don't want her to hold any of her accessories. But I like the accessories, so I am going to, have her hold them. I mean, that's kind of the point. She comes with them. Now I'm kind of worried that this... So I'm gonna actually put the heart back in, and we're gonna end the video in just a moment. And I'm sorry if you can hear a dog. I'm right by the window, and I need a better review area and better lighting. So on all, she is a fantastic figure in my opinion. Not perfect. I don't think there's really the perfect figure. I mean, maybe there is, but she is fantastic. She is very good. For the first Regina action figure, I think they did a very good job. She comes and really fast, just because I forgot to show this with the figure, I did want to bring in the animated Evil Queen, just so you can see what they look like together. This is actually a little statue, it's not a figure. And, I like how them both. These two are my, favorite Evil Queens. There's so many different versions of the Evil Queen, but these two are the best, in my opinion. And, but my favorite will always be the animated version. She has a very special place in my heart, and she's the best, in my opinion. But Regina is by far the best live-action Evil Queen that there is. I don't think there... I mean, Charlize Theron is good, too, but she doesn't outdo, Lana. I think Lana is a little bit better. So, I just wanted to show, you these guys together, and let me know which one you look like. You guys look... like better, or if you guys like both, or yeah. So, all right, thank you for watching. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address if you would like to send fan mail. Feel free to do so, and I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel, and have a great day. Bye. The queen is dead. Long live the... Excuse me? No. Who the hell are you? I'm the Evil Queen. I'm the only Evil Queen. Think again. I'm the Evil Queen. I was created in 1937. Who do you think you are? Can't we both be the Evil Queen? I am the jealous type. I don't think so. Eat an apple. Oh! Now, the queen is dead. Long live the evil queen. Are you alright, dear? I think she's passed out.